Does your wife know how lucky she is, man?
I mean, you know, it's just like her and Lindsay, my brother-in-law, I mean, Smith works. They don't know how blessed they are.
I know.
There you go.
I think it was that stob. I think they had a stob on the back right there that had it held up. Thank you. that's the one that's bigger than this one, right?
An 88 is the next size up. This is 65. 88 is the next one. But it and the boom ain't the butt, it ain't that much different than the regional, not much at all, but it gives. You know, it's got a little more capability. And I think on the new 88's got a different style tubing.
So I'll give you $100K for this one.
I bet you will. $100K would almost buy the truck. Yeah, six.
on it too. Yeah. You got a flow valve out there on the head then to turn it in, or can you do it from the remote? Okay, I got you.
So I asked one of the guys if they're welding. He was welding. I said, you know, how long does it take, you know, y'all to get put one out? He said, about 4 weeks. And I said, well, I understood that y'all are X amount of months behind or whatever. He said, that may be what they're telling you. He said, it ain't that far. It don't take that long to get one. I think he said, what he was telling me is that at the time that I went and bought this one, they were struggling with all the COVID junk. They were struggling with getting enough trucks in to build, or the right sizes to build the ones that people are requesting. This, he says, is the most popular model.
So he's going to slow the saw bar down just a little bit on this thing.
I'll show y'all where it's at. So this little dial here, you see it says plus or minus.
Right.
But here's the deal. If it had a gauge on it, like if it had a point, you know, to tell you where to start and stop, like this, you can turn this thing just a hair more and it's wide open, and you can turn it about a 16th of a turn.
And it's closed.
And it's closed. That's all the dial there is. I don't know why there's a plus and minus like that, but so watch, this is all I'm gonna do.
You don't want anything flying when you're working up high like that or whatever, you know, like rolling.
Yeah.
Let's just take it easy, man.
Yeah. Yep. You know what RPM that team comes around compared to like a steel or a burner?
I have no idea.
Those are usually going to be about the same. It should be about 7,500, 8,000 RPM. Some of them even get up around 9,000. But that motor can only take so much. See. Let it do the work, yeah.
It's a lot easier than starting over starting to bug you to death. I just thought, you know, whatever setting it was should cut through anything, and then watch all the other guys that had the same, you know, jet pedal finger and the channel. They're like, no, you gotta turn it down on big wood and speed it up a little on little cut. Little things you gotta learn.
I think it's all the way right there.
I think it's moved.
Yeah. There you go. It's there, very good. You can feel it in the crane here, that's the weight there on it.
Well, when it moves too much, it's just that the pads have settled.
Right.
You just gotta reset your pads. Just kinda bump them up a little bit if you need to.
That's a pretty good chunk right there.
It just tells me a percentage of what my crane's doing. Gives you a percentage, so
Yeah, you know, not
80-90%. You know, you're a little high on it.
Yes, it is. Yeah, that'd be dirty right there if you did that, man. Straight down, straight down, straight down. All right, grab it. It's amazing how strong that crane is. Yeah. 50%. Well, you ain't got nothing out on it, hardly. Yeah, you increase that capacity when you pull in there. Now don't hit the truck. We done got this far along. Yeah. I know. Oh, you've got 2 more foot right there you can swing, but you got it. Now you can get your wedge. We're slaying trees with Rook today.
We done slayed several already. It's too wet to about work anywhere, but we still slaying trees.
I know. Does your wife know how lucky she is, man?
I mean, you know, this is like her and Lindsay, my brother-in-law. I mean, Smith works. They don't know how blessed they are.
I know. I mean, look, she's got a guy. He's got a tree mag. And just smoke trees. I mean, we done done 3 today already like that. And it's not even nowhere near quitting time yet.
No. We're about to drive till quitting time. Yeah. Slaying a couple little baby ones.
And get some more quick. Yeah.
It's Friday, that's what we do.
It's all good, yeah. Take a little bit of time off on Thursday and work like crazy on Friday.
You gotta make up for it, man. You gotta make up for it. It rained a lot yesterday. Yeah, it did. We got a lot of work to do, but all of it's in yards, man. You can't, and even with the mech, there's only so much. I mean, you're gonna reach 100 feet, you can't reach 900 feet, so.
So we're up at Corinth, Mississippi, is where we're at right now. This is about, for me, it's roughly about 100, right at 100 miles from my house, or was it probably 30 miles above Tupelo?
It's more like, yeah, close.
40 miles?
More, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, 40, so something like that.
It's about 2 hours, yeah.
Yeah. So we're going to head back. We're going back to Amory now real quick, so we're going to do. And
it's like it's real quick.
Knock, yeah. It ain't going to be real quick, but we're finna go knock out a little bit more while the getting's good. Get it done.
Gotta take advantage of having you with me, man. I mean, we should have started at 6 o'clock.
I know, right?
But you stayed up all night, man.
I know, man. Dang. I was still running saws at midnight last night.
Man.
Dang, boy.
I didn't hear from you this morning. I was like, man, I hope he's coming.
Yeah. Yeah. I got on the road and I wanted to make sure y'all wasn't gonna, you know, just take off and leave or whatever. Yeah. That's why I texted you. My ETA was straight up 8.
Yeah.
And a little disappointed Lindsay didn't stay there and wait on me.
Though. I know, maybe, but, like, seriously, maybe 10 minutes. He left 10 minutes before he got there. Yeah. I was like, you know, Tim's on the way. He's like, when? I was like, today. He's like, he's coming here. I was like, yeah.
He got mad because you didn't say anything to him about it. See, yeah,
I didn't let him. You gotta, with everything with Lindsay, you gotta give him a month's advance notice of what you're gonna do. Like, if you want him to help you, you're like, hey, in a month, my lift's gonna break down. I need you to be there to help me. Uh-huh. And he's like, no, you know, I need 2 months. Like, no matter how much advance you give him, he wants more. If you don't, like, personally invite him, send him a written letterhead with your business on it, invite him to dinner, he ain't coming. You got to tell him 2 months ahead of time.
I got you. He's like one of them type people.
Yeah, he's
you got to coddle him a little bit.
Yeah, he's important.
Yeah.
Busy man.
Stop. So we're fixing to leave. Car rent. It's been fun up here, y'all.
Call us when you need us.
Yeah.
You need the A-team.
Yeah, we're going to head back kind of southeast for a little ways, a couple hours here, so.